Hey guys, how's it going? Today we're going to be building a simple timer app in Android Studio using Java. There's a link in the description to the source code as always. So yeah, we're just going to have a basic window with a stop-start button, a reset button, and the timer. You're going to be able to start and stop the timer. It's going to count up from zero to infinity. Maybe not infinity, but anyway, there's going to be a reset button. We're going to do a bit of validation, so make sure that user really does want to reset the button. So yeah, when they hit the reset button, we'll show them a little alert dialog to say, do you really want to reset the timer? So I'll show you how to do that. And yeah, we're just going to build it all. It's going to look a little bit something like this. So yeah, stick around.
Cool, so I'm just starting a new Android Studio project. I'm naming this one Timer. And then I'm just going to go get my layout sorted. I'm just going to change this to a linear layout. And then I'm just going to put in some colors. So I'm just putting in red, green, gray. This isn't necessary, but it just makes it all look a little bit nicer. And then I'm going to get rid of this text view here. And I'm going to put in a toolbar. And I'm just going to say width match parent, height wrap content, giving it my background color gray. And then in my toolbar, I'm going to give it a text view, just name it timer, and I'm giving it black, layout gravity center, and give it a nice big text size there of 30 SP. And then I'm going to have a button. This button is going to be called reset, and giving it null background, it's going to be red, and 30 SP as well, so nice and big. And then I'm going to do another button. So this is going to be the stop start button. So I'm just calling it start for now, but that's going to toggle later on. So yeah, I'm just going to start's going to be green, positive kind of color, and same text size, 30 SP. And I'm going to set the gravity to the end there, and I'm just giving it a little bit of margin, make it look a little bit nicer there. Cool, and then we just want another text view. This text view even bigger, so this is going to contain our actual time, giving it the color of black, and just putting in the middle. I realized I needed to give the orientation vertical jack for that to actually show up, so that's what I've done there. And margin at the top is 40 dp. Cool, so I think that's all of our UI done. Next, I'm just going to set some on-click listeners. So reset tapped and start stop tapped and just opening them up there. And then I'm going to give my buttons an ID. So I'm called this one start stop button. And I'm going to give the text view timer text as its ID. Should have given that a lowercase. There we go. Timer text. Cool. So I'm just going to do a little bit of setup to start. Just going to set our timer text view and our stop start button. Just going to declare them and find them by their layouts. So if you've not done this before, it gets pretty repetitive in Android Studio programming, finding views by ID, but yeah, just follow along here. So yeah, see, I found that timer text by that ID. And then I'm going to just declare a boolean. I've called it timer started, and I'm going to give it equal to false. And then in our start stop tapped, if the timer started is false, I'm going to set it to true and set the text to be stop. Otherwise, if the timer hasn't started, I'm going to set the timer started to false, and stop starting button, I'm going to set it to start. So you get how that works. It's kind of like a toggle, really. I'm just setting the text color here. Make it all a little bit prettier. I always found that this set text color was pretty annoying. I have to do the context compat get color r dot id. It just seems like so over the top. But anyway, that's something for another day. Yeah, so set that to red and set that to green on the toggle. And then I'm going to declare my timer. And I'm just going to say timer is equal to new timer. And I'm going to declare a timer task and a double time, and just giving it to zero to start with. Cool. And in our start stop tapped, I'm just going to create a new method called start timer and create that down there. And I'm just going to say timer task is equal to new timer task, and just autocomplete that over that override method there, that run. And then each time it gets run, I'm just going to say time plus one, and then I'm going to set the text to, so we're actually going to create a new method called getTimerText, and that's going to return a string. And I'm just going to declare an int. I'm rounding our double to an int, so just rounding it off. And I'm going to declare a seconds. And this is the bit of funky maths that I basically just looked at Stack Overflow how to do this bit. But basically, with a full time, this is how you get the seconds. You can look the maths up for yourself, but I don't know. I just kind of go, oh, it works so well. So yeah, you can see the different maths for hours, minutes, and seconds. And then I'm just going to create another method, and this is going to format our time into our timer string. So we just give it the seconds, the minutes, and the hours. And I'm just saying string format that int to two decimal places, and then I'm going to give it the hours, give it a bit of space, and the little two dots. What are they called? I don't know. It doesn't matter. Those two little dots, and then minutes and seconds. So let me just back up to below our run method. I'm just going to say timer.schedule at fixed rate. I'm going to give it the timer task. I'm going to give it a delay of zero, so we want it to start straight away. And then the period is 1,000, and I believe it's in milliseconds. So 1,000 milliseconds is 1 second. Cool. So a couple of things I just forgot to do. In our else statement here, I just need to say timer task.cancel. And then in our run, I need to put it in this thread. So run on the UI thread. And threads are just basically a way to multitask better. So if you've got something really intensive, you want to do it on a background thread, but this is just a simple timer. So we're just going to do it on the main UI thread. Cool. So next we're going to get our reset button working. So I'm actually going to do an alert dialog for this so that it prompts the user, it makes sure they really do want to reset the timer. I think it's just good practice. So we're just going to say alert dialog.builder, calling it reset alert. Giving a context of this, I'm going to set the title to reset timer. I'm setting the message here. Are you sure you want to reset the timer? And I'm just going to set a positive button here. I'm going to give it a title of reset. And then I'm just going to say new dialog interface dot onclick listener and just autocomplete that override onclick method. So I'm just going to copy and paste that set positive button method, just changing it to set neutral button and change the text there to cancel. And then on our click of our cancel, we actually just want to do nothing. But if we click on our reset button, I'm just going to check to see if the timer task is null. And I'm just going to say timer task.cancel. Next, I want to set our stop button to start and give it the color of green. So I'm actually just going to go refactor this into a method because I'm going to call it twice. So I've called that set button UI. And I'm just going to change that into color there because that makes a bit more sense. And then we can just copy and paste this method call. We're going to reset our time back to zero. Timer started is equal to false. And we're going to say timer text.setText. And we're going to format the time to 000. So that's calling that bottom method we created. And finally, I'm just going to call show on our reset alert. Cool, and we should be able to run this, and you can see, we've got our timer here. You can hit start, stop, stopped it at 5 seconds, and start it again. And then I'm going to say reset, and it prompts you, are you sure you want to reset the timer? We straight reset it, you can see it went back to zero there. And just one more test I want to do. I want to see that my hours and minutes are working correctly. So I'm changing this period to one, and I've run that again, and you can see it's quickly going up quite fast. And there you go, 1 hour and 30, faster than I can say. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed the video. Remember to like and subscribe, all that jazz, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.